Look how easy it is to create some money and to maximize your output in Illustrator. Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to create this stack of money. So I'm going to start by drawing just one piece of money, and you see that thing gets applied immediately, and I don't want that. We cannot have that. So what I'm going to do is open the appearance panel and let's just get rid of that and just apply a basic stroke. And then also let's turn on this so we just get basic appearances. And now we are going to draw that piece of money, that coin, and I have selected this bottom point. I'm going to copy it and then paste in front. I'm using the shortcuts, which is Command C, Command F, and on Windows, of course, this would be Control. So let's just close this and here as well. Like so. And again, I'm going to copy these and then let's take the Shape Builder tool and just click here. So we've got this, like so. Okay. So we have the black strokes and I like it that way. And then we've got some filled elements and that's why I needed the copy. So let's go to the swatches panel and let's just fill them. So there are the swatches, and also I'm going to open the color panel because I want to edit that slightly. So let's apply just yellow and I'm going to tone that down and make that slightly brown, and let's get out that red shade. Like so. So maybe like this. And then we can also get rid of the stroke. And then let's take this. And for this, I'm going to apply a gradient. So we've got the gradients and there is the metal in here. So let's see that we can find it in here. There are the metals. And I'm going to use this one and I've applied it to the stroke. Let's get it to the fill. Okay, like so. So let's take the gradient panel and I need to just flip that like so and just move this slightly to the left and get it darker down there, like so. So that's nice. But also we want to have this kind of grip that this has. And in order to create that, we need to expand that gradient. And we need to expand it anyway, because we cannot use a gradient in this case. So I'm going to Object, Expand, and then let's set this to 40. Like so. Okay. So just to show you what it has created, we're going into Outline View. This is it. So there's a clipping mask on it and I'm going to expand that as well. So let's go to the Pathfinder panel and just click here. And now we've expanded that mask. And then I'm going to zoom in slightly more and let's just select every second one of those, like so, and I'm going to apply a slightly darker tint to them. And let's do it on the other side as well. So again, every second one of them, like so. Okay, and apply a slightly darker tint to them. And there we've got the base artwork. Let's zoom out and then let's move it up here again. This doesn't need to be perfect. I like that slightly irregular look. And this is grouped, nice. So let's get it in here and select the two. I'm going to cut them and paste them in the back, like so. And then we can use the arrow keys to adjust their position, like so. Okay, so this is the base artwork. And now what we need to do is rotate this, like so. And then in order to create this stack making machine, we're going to use brushes. Just select the whole thing and drag it in there. Create a scatter brush and let's call that money and just leave it like it is. We're going to take a look at it, how it looks. So draw a straight line and just apply that. And you see, this is how this works. Pretty nice, but not perfect. So let's double click this and adjust it. The preview is turned on. And what we're now going to do is align this to the path. That is important because we need to be able to later make the vertical stacks and then the spacing. Adjust the spacing. And you see, now they get closer together. What you also see is obviously the scatter brush adds them behind the previous item that it added on that path. Now what we want is a slight irregularity. So let's turn on the scatter to random and let's just make this here and that there. So we get irregular spacing like so. Okay, apply this. And now comes the nice thing in order to draw with it. So we're going to deactivate this again. And let's take just the line tool. And when I now draw this, then you see Illustrator stacks them. And you see when I draw a second stack, then it's really randomized. So like so. What I can't do is draw them from bottom to top. That doesn't work, obviously. So let's undo that. You have to draw them like so. And now we're done. But we can add something else. So let's go into this again. And then what you can turn on is the hue shift. And what this does is when you now apply a different stroke color, let's set this to like red, then you see they take on that color and all the hues shift around the color wheel to adjust to that. And of course, this is too extreme, but like when you have slightly darker tints, or let's draw another one. So like so, maybe you have also silver coins, then you can add it like so, with a gray tint. And then you see you get also differently colored coins as a stack. So there's a great use case for scatter brushes in order to draw more quickly.